Assalamu alaikum students, how are you all? I hope that you all are doing great. Welcome to your channel, my D1D2 Scientific Academy. Today our lecture is related to chapter 5, which is algebraic fractions and graph. I'm going to explain you exercise 5B, question number 11. Your book is D2 Math and SM2. So question number 11 is, Amira walks at an average speed of x plus 1 km per hour for x hours and cycles at an average speed of 2x plus 5 km per hour for x minus 1 hour. She covers a total distance of 90 km. So what's given in the question? Basically, Amira's speed, average speed and time is given to you. That when she walks, so this is her average speed, which is x plus 1. And this is the time, that in this time, in x hours, she covers this total speed. Okay. And then also it's also written that when she cycles, okay, when she cycles, so this is her average speed, which is 2x plus 5, and this time, which is x minus 1. So now we know two things, okay, in this question, two things are given, average speed when she walks and time when she walks, okay, and average speed and time when she cycles. So two things are given and total distance is given, which is 90 km. In part 1, they are saying that form an equation in x and show that it reduces to 3x square plus 4x minus 95 is equal to 0. So we have to make this equation by using this information. Okay. So in part 1. Okay. So I'm explaining you exercise 5B. Question number 11. Okay. Do you know that what's the formula to find out the average speed? The formula to find out the average speed is, total distance divided by total time. Okay, so when she walks, so average speed when she walks. Okay, so here when she walks, we have to put the average speed over here and we have to put the total distance. We do not know the total distance, we just know the time. I will just put the average speed when she walks and the time, and I'll just put the values in the formula. So students, average speed is given when she walks. Okay, write down over here, walks, where she walks. Okay, so average speed is x plus 1. And total distance, we do not know the total distance. Write down total distance as it is. And time is given to you, which is x, okay? So this x is dividing over here. When we go to this side, we multiply with x plus 1. So we can find out total distance by multiplying this x with this x plus 1. So total distance will be equal to x and x plus 1. Okay, gee. Now, in the same way, we have to find out the total distance when she cycles. Okay, so when she cycles, the formula is same, total distance divided by total time. So total distance is given to you, distance you have to find out. And so every speed when she cycles is given to you, which is 2x plus 5. We have to find out the total distance and time is given, which is x minus 1. So you can find out total distance when she cycles by multiplying this x minus 1 with this 2x plus 5. This x minus 1 is dividing over here, it will go to that side, will be multiplied. So it will become, here it will become 2x plus 5. X minus 1 is equal to total distance. Now we have found the total distance when she cycles and we have found the total distance when she walks. So let's do it now. Now what's the next step? So we have found the total distance when she walks. When she walks, so the total distance is x and we have to multiply average speed and the time. So x and x plus 1. In the same way, when she cycles, the total distance is, TD stands for total distance. We have to multiply the time and the average speed. which is 2x plus 5 and x minus 1. Now the total distance in the question is given. Okay, what is that? So we have to find out the total distance. We have to add these both. Okay, when she walks and when she cycles. Okay, so total distance is equal to, you have to add these both distances, which is x plus 1 when she walks and when she cycles. Okay, ji. So total distance in the question is given, which is 90 kilometers. So write down 90 over here. And now we have to solve this equation. Multiply x with that, so you will get x here. Multiply this x with 1, so you will get plus x. Now in the same way, first multiply this x with this whole bracket. So what you will get? Plus x 2x r 2x here. X 5 r 5x. Okay, now we have multiplied this x with these two numbers. Now we'll multiply this one with these two numbers. Remember, students, whenever you multiply, always multiply the signs as well. As this is minus now, and with 2x it's plus. So plus minus is minus, 2 ones are 2x. And plus minus is minus, 5 ones are 5. So this is the equation. Now solve it. What we will get? We will get 90 is equal to, I said x square and 2x square, it will become 3x square. And x plus 5x minus 2x. X plus 5x is 6x. 6x minus 2x is 4x. And there is only one constant, which is minus 5. I said, as we have to make the equation 3x square plus 4x minus 95. As you can see that this 90 is adding over here, it will go to that side, will be subtracted. So when it will be subtracted, what you will get? Here 0 will be left. So 3x square plus 4x minus 5 minus 90. So you will get 3x square plus 4x minus. Minus minus is plus. You will add these both values. So minus 95 is equal to 0. So this is the equation which we have to prove in part 1. Now let's come to part 2. I just was now in part 2, we have to solve the equation, okay? So the equation which we have derived in part 1 was 3x square plus 4x minus 95 is equal to 0. We have to solve this equation now. So first write down the equation, which is 3x square plus 4x minus 95 is equal to 0. We can factorize it. So multiply 95 with 3, what you will get? When I will multiply 95 with 3, I will get 285. Okay, now I have to choose two factors, 285. Mid factor is 4. Now I have to choose two factors, that when I will multiply, I will get 285, and when I will subtract or add, I will get 4. As a students, now those two factors are 19 and 15. Okay, when you multiply 19 and 15, you will get 285. And when you will subtract 15 from 19, you will get 4. Okay, how did 285 come? When I multiplied 95 and 3, I got 285. Now I have to choose two factors, that when I will multiply them, I will get 284. And when I will add or subtract, I will get the midterm, which is 4. So those two factors are 19 and 15. Now write down the factors. 3x square. Now follow the rule. First you have to write down this sign. And you have to write down the bigger factor first, which is 19x. Now what should be the other factor so that you can get 4? So when you will subtract 15 from 19, then you will get 4. So it means that the other sign should be minus. Okay, now I'll write down the last term as it is. I have written these two terms and these two factors in place of the midterm. Now what's common between 3 and 19? There is nothing common, so I can take x common. Just x is common in these two terms. So 3x is left over here and 19 is left over here. And minus here, I can take 5 common. 5 threes are 15 and 5 ones are 5, 5 nines are 45. I just was, as you can see, that there is a minus sign outside the bracket, so the sign inside the bracket will be changed. Okay, gee. So with they both, these two both are equal to 0. Now what's common? These two terms, 3x plus 19 is common. So I can take 3x plus 19 common. what's left here? It's x is left and here 5 is left. These both are equal to 0. Now I can make these two brackets equal to 0. So 3x plus 19 is equal to 0 and x minus 5 is equal to 0. Now this is 19 and this is 3x. When 19 is adding over here, it will come to this side, it will be subtracted. And this is multiplying with x, when it will come to this side, it will be divided with 19. In the same way over here, 5 is subtracting, it will go to that side, it will be added. Okay. Just was in part 2, it was written that solve the equation 3x square plus 4x minus. We have to find out the time taken for the entire journey in part 3. So we need value of x now. So time cannot be in negative numbers. Okay, time cannot be negative. So we just have to consider the positive value of x, which is 5. So in part 3, now part 2 is solved. We have solved for x. Okay, now part 3 is to find the time taken for her entire journey. So when she walks, okay, we have to find time. We have to add the time when she walks and with the time when she cycles. We have to add both times. So the time when she walks was x plus, and time when she cycles was x minus 1. So the time when she walks was x and time when she cycles was with x minus 1 hours. Now put value of x, substitute value of x, which is 5. I'm finding out total time. So 5 plus 5 minus 1. So 5 plus 5 minus 1 is 4. So I will get 9 hours. So this is your answer. Okay, students, I hope that today's concept is clear to you. Do the practice of this sum, because when you do the practice, this concept will be more clear to you. Take very good care of yourself. Thank you very much, and Allah Hafiz.